In this video, we are going to design the best hydraulic section of this triangle channel. Here on the right, we have the data. A design flow equal to 706.29 cubic feet per second. A size slope equal to 1.00. A roughness coefficient equal to 0.017. And a longitudinal slope equal to 2.64 feet per mile, equal to 0.0005. We had to find the top width of the channel and the depth water. Let's start by calculating the optimal depth for line canal minimum weighted perimeter criterion. For the United States units, we are using this equation that is true for side slope equal to 1. If you use the metric system or international system of units, you should use this equation. True for side slope equal to 1. Substituting data, the water depth is equal to 2 multiplied by flow design multiplied by roughness coefficient between 1.486 multiplied by longitudinal slope to the power of 1/2 all of this to the power of 3/8, and the water depth is equal to 11.81 feet. The freeboard goes from 0.1 multiplied by water depth to 0.3 multiplied by water depth. The freeboard is equal to 0.2 multiplied by water depth, equal to 2.36 feet. The optimal side slope, as I was saying, is equal to 1. The optimal top width is equal to 2 multiplied by side slope multiplied by water depth. The top width is equal to 23.61 feet. The cross sectional area is equal to side slope multiplied by water depth squared, equal to 139.4 square feet. And the weighted perimeter is equal to multiplied by water depth multiplied by side slope square plus 1 to the power of 1/2. The weighted perimeter equal to 33.59 feet. Result: the top width of the channel is equal to 23.61 feet. The water depth is equal to 11.81 feet. And the freeboard is equal to 2.36 feet. 36 feet, and the size log that was a data equal to 1. Well, we have finished. If you like it, subscribe and give the like.